sitting in my little bitty boat with my little bitty fishing pole on a little bitty creek. Somebody tied it there for a reason. But it's been there for a minute. They might have used it to help get a towel out or out of the creek or something, I don't know. Tie a boat there? Oh. Right now it's there to catch the trees and shit. Campground. Well, if you go camping in something as big as my house, it's like you just moved your house somewhere. And some of them campers, man, are bigger than my trailer. Yeah, my trailer ain't but 38 foot. There's a fish over there coming. Where's he at? Get him, cub. Kinda cool shit to pick it. Big ass monster crew. Catch it on film. We start us a fishing channel on the YouTube. Call it Country Hicks in the Creek. I got a fishing line. Whether it's in date or not, I'm not 100% sure. But hell, I'll pay a ticket, I don't give a shit. As long as he wasn't a dick about it. Take my fishing pole away from it. Every game warden I've ever run across is a dick. One of those was down on a hunting club or whatever, Dad and Uncle Bob. And game warden come out there, try to take their guns and their truck and all that. His man, Dad tells his man, we're out in the middle of nowhere. There's two of us, and you're going to take our guns and all our equipment and everything? I don't think so. Well, little young punk didn't realize who he was fucking with. Yeah, some of them young ones, they get cocky as fuck. Dad and Uncle Bob took that away in like 2 seconds. Click, click. Well, said, well, them big 5 gallon buckets gonna come up and grab my worm right here by the kite. So you always want to miss a big old fish now, we'll have evidence. Won't be none of this hearsay shit. Every time I come by. They missed the key word. Float the creek, not race down the creek. There goes the dinghy. Kayaking trip, if nobody shows up and we got an extra kayak, I know what it's getting used for. Well, I can get Craig and Rachel.
Campers got to Tennessee for a few days. Then they bailed out on him, but I always wanted to go there. Glad that he was fucking calling his over, you know, get reservations.
Yeah. Something might have come up, man.
The company always comes up with them, unless they want you to come with them, but if you make plans to go do something, you can take them with you, something always comes up. They do it too tomorrow, always. Rachel, I said, I'd appreciate it if you just wouldn't ask her until y'all know for sure, because she gets all excited about it.
Yeah.
I like it don't bother her, but I know my daughter. I can tell her.
I got all excited about Mama Sue coming out here with me and bailed out on me.
I worry about Mama not being able to get in and out of the house.
You don't think I'd help her get in out of the house? I had to, I couldn't get out.
Enjoy this.
I enjoy the hell out of her enjoying the hell out of it. that would definitely go into one of my cherished memory banks. Would not be forgotten, that's for sure. Well, see, if Miss Sue come with me, I wouldn't come here. I'd launch out at Bowling Bridge, but I know they keep it cleared out. When the water's up, that one's awesome as hell. But right now, it'd be a lot of work.
Next year when I take my vacation, we'd be playing like they were at Little River Canyon or something, or somewhere like that.
You got all these big waterfalls.
Somewhere. Investigation.
That place where me and Benji went? Over by the racetrack was pretty cool. But you had to leave the vehicle. Like I can just quit.
Stuff, take it to the machine shop, let them hone it out, and pay charge $75 to put it fucking together for you, you know?
Yeah.
You just have to go on and get put in the fucking truck, and then you're done. I'll be like my mother from the Monte Carlo where I just sit out there while I was working on the car. And I'm trying to get rid of something wrong with it, and I can't get them fixed. I guarantee they put one of the pistons in the wrong hole is what it felt like.
Looks like you're gonna have to get your whacker out here in a minute.
I like getting a whacker out.
Well, if you don't do that whacker on me, I'll be alright. Almost got your ass with a chainsaw yesterday. Man, I was around down there at Mr. James's, cleaning out the weeds around his fence and stuff.
Yeah.
And I was all up in what I was doing, man. Used to being by myself and shit.
Yeah.
Next thing I know, I seen a hand reach in there, man. I about cut it off. I was just using the end of the chainsaw to knock the limbs out of my way, you know? Keep them from falling on me. He reached in there to grab the limb. About cut his damn hand off. But don't do that, Mr. James, dude. I'm in the middle. Yeah, I get that, Mr. James, but I'm used to working by myself, buddy.